There's many symptoms to really bad PowerPoint. One is you put every single word on the slide. Another symptom of death by PowerPoint is making things move on the screen for no apparent reason. Things that spin or move around or shoot onto the screen, they can really distract what you're trying to say. Your audience is not remembering what you're saying. They're looking at the things spinning on the screen over and over again. So we want to do animations, and we want to do them more smartly so you can have a better impact with your presentation. So we're going to talk about animation without being dorky. But let's talk a little bit about being dorky, shall we? Let's show you a couple of these things that I have seen definitely over time and that you have seen too. Things that spin, or anytime there's a running person, they seem to have to run onto the stage, or balls need to bounce. It's just, no one's even listening to what I'm saying anymore. They're just watching these boxes move. So that's what we want to stop from doing. Before I get into the how-to, I want to talk about a few little rules. I was down at Presentation Summit, which is a great conference for people who do presentations. It's hosted by Rick Altman, who's done a lot with PowerPoint, and he did a talk about animation that luckily I went to because I had scheduled this webinar before I went there. And he shows some rules, some things I wanted to share with you. And one is, anytime that you have something moving on the screen, even if it's words that are appearing, that's where the attention goes. So if you just have a bouncing ball or a coin that's spinning, and it just spins the entire time, people are going to watch the coin. They're going to think, maybe it's going to do something else besides spin. So you want to use your animations and your movement in PowerPoint carefully. And again, he has us take this oath that just because we know how to do this doesn't mean we will do this. Just like we know we can put every word on a slide doesn't mean we should put it everywhere on the slide. He also talks about separating the structure of the slide from the data, because the data is usually what you want to talk about, especially if you get into graphs, and we'll show that here in just a moment. So again, a couple things here. I'm going to show several things in one slide. I probably would never do that normally, but I just want to show you different types of animation that we have. You can bring in pictures. You can bring in text. Now, I did this for Rick. Instead of one line at a time, you're going to see all the text all at once. And Rick's a big fan of that, because why anticipatory? Why make it so each click is going to be something on the mouse? So if you have something like this, which is an arrival time about an event, put everything up there at once. Don't bring it in one point at a time. The graph is already there, so it's the data that we're going to show. And you can do that with clicks, and we'll show you how to do that. And one of the ones that people forget about that I like using sometimes is color. With a click, you can change the color of things, and that is still animation. So there's just several things you can do. Just don't put everything on one slide at once, please. But let's kind of dig into some of these animations. We're going to build a slide here. Let me show you one. Let's say I'm presenting this brand new, our company has just expanded. We're going worldwide, and we have a new logo and a new tagline. So we're going to show some animation for that. So with this, I have the tagline appearing first, and I'm just clicking for each line of animation. Click once, click again, click a third time, and now the logo appears, and click a fourth time, and the little heart element appears. So four clicks get me four bits of animation. We're gonna build that slide, and we're gonna build it by kind of three different things. We're gonna select an object, we're gonna animate it, and then we're gonna edit it, or you work on some effects. And sometimes people forget the effects. That's an important part of just not using the pre-made animation. Okay, so here's this slide, and let's now build it. So I'm gonna escape out of slide mode, and now I'm here in PowerPoint 2013. Everything I'm showing, though, is gonna be available in other versions of PowerPoint, pretty much. So let's go into the animations slide. And then I have three different elements on this page. I have a tagline, I have the logo, and I have the little heart there. Oop, come on, little heart. There we go. So three different boxes I'm going to animate. So if you want to do animation, again, click on the object you want to animate. Let's just look at that heart for a moment. Okay. And then you click on the type of animation you want, and you'll actually see it happen. So here's a fly-in. And you can see that. And again, on the live, you may not see it appear. But there's different animations. And as you just click on it, it previews that. And you can pick a whole bunch. I mean, you looked at this menu. You have entrance, emphasis, exits. You can enter something, emphasize it, and then have it leave. but don't do that, okay? Again, we want to use this smartly. Okay, if you do anything besides just a simple animation, you want to use the animation, and even if that, you probably want to use the animation pane. If you look in the upper right-hand corner here of the ribbon, animation pane, I'm going to click on that, and then you can see your animation. So again, that little heart animation is represented by that green bar. We'll show you that works. Let's build everything, though. I'm going to actually make this animation go away, so we'll click None. And we're going to build this. I want to build this from the ground up. I'm going to build the tagline, then the logo, and then the heart. So I'm going to click the tagline first, and I'm going to have this float in. So I'm going to click the float in. Sorry, Rick. Not a fan of that one. And then I'm going to pick my effect options. Now, here there's only two options. I can have it float up, which it just did, or have it float down. I'm going to actually have it float down. And it looks like it's going through the logo, but remember the logo won't be there. This will be the first part of the animation. I'm going to build from the ground up. Now, the other thing I can do with effect options here is I can actually have this sequence. So I can actually do it by paragraph. So each line will come in one after the other. So click for the things, click that really matter. I can change that too. Let's go over to the animation pane and see these animations here. The second line here, there's a little tiny star, that means entrance, and next to that is a little tiny mouse. That means you have to click each one. And I'm going to change that. Because that second line, I just want it to appear. So I'm going to click on that second line in the animation pane, and I'm going to go up to timing. And there's three timings. You can do it on a click, you can do it with the previous animation. I want to do mine after the previous. And look what happens to the green bar when I do that. It shifts, it goes, so that's actually a graphic representation of the animation. First the first line, then comes the second line. In fact, you know what I'm gonna do with the second line? I'm gonna change the effect, so that's gonna come up. So one line's gonna come down, one line's gonna come up on the animation. Let's quickly add the other animation. So the logo, I click on that box, we'll have that fade in, and then the heart, I'll click on that, and we'll have, I was gonna do something silly, but I can't do it. We'll just have it fade in. And now the animation pane has three steps. The first two is in one step, then click for the rectangle and click for the heart. Now the heart, I also wanted to just appear. I don't have to click for the heart to appear. So I'm going to go over to timing after previous. And you can see it shifts there again. Now let's go back to that rectangle, which is my main logo. Look at the timing. That's only a half a second. That's pretty quick. I want it to build. This is our big moment, right? So I'm going to click the timing bar, and as I do, you can watch the green bar, and it gets longer as I do that. I think each click is, what, a quarter of a second here? So let's do a three-second fade in. And notice that the heart always stays after because it's always after the previous. Now, those green bars you can also move. If I wanted to have the heart animation first, I can just click and drag it up. And now that becomes the first animation. I'll undo that. And then I can also, let's say I don't like the heart. The design team put the heart in, and I really don't like the heart. So I'm going to control the heart. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have it fade a little longer, so I'm actually going to drag the green bar a little bit. And then I'm going to move the entire green bar. And I'm going to space it out. So what happens here is the Contoso logo will appear, then there'll be a period of nothing happening, and then the heart will appear. I'll show you why I do that in just a second. So I think I'm ready to go. Now, one thing, that first animation happens on a click. A lot of people want the animation to start as soon as you switch a slide. And so what you choose there is click that first element and click on after previous. The previous being the slide changing. So the slide changes and the animation appears. But that can be a problem, and I'll show you why. If I have it that way, let's go to the slideshow. And let me get my thumbnails out here. If I'm on this slide, and I know the next slide, I'm talking numbers, I'm talking our figures and all that. I am talking numbers. Look, they're big. The next slide I know is the big reveal. I'm going to show you the new tagline, the new logo. But I don't want this slide to be on when I'm talking about that. That's kind of, you know, out of context. But I know if I click my button, it's going to appear. So that's why I want to make sure the animation starts on a click. So let's go over here again. And that first animation, I want to start on a click. And here's, and then now we'll show it. So I'm on this slide. I go to slideshow. I'm talking about numbers. And now I want to talk. Now I want to switch the tone of our talk to our big reveal. So I'm going to click for the next slide, but the animation will not appear until I click. So now we have a nice blank slide. The focus is on me, on the words I'm talking about our big new change. Here comes our new tagline. We've already tested this with 150 of our customers. We have a 98% approval rating, and here it is for the things that really matter. And then I can wait, and then when I'm ready to reveal the logo, I click again. Contoso, and we're now international. Wild applause. They love it. They think it's great. And they won't even notice because it takes a couple seconds that the heart appears. See, the heart's just kind of buried in the applause. So that's how you can build that slide. Let's look at some other ways. Let's look at a graph. And as you notice, I have a very simple graph here. We should probably do a talk about using graphs and numbers in talks. You want something very simple. And I can animate this by our sections. Our west section, I click once, I get those numbers. I click the central, I get those numbers. I click the east, and I get those numbers. But the thing is, if you notice those numbers, and let's say they're quarterly numbers, that pink bar at the end is really big. That's our story. We had a really great fourth quarter. So let's animate that a little differently. So I'm going to escape out of that and click on and get into animation. And as you can see, the animation is on the side for each section. I'm going to go to the animation. I have this wipe animation, and I can go to effect options. I can now, there's different options here. I can swipe from left to right if I want to. Why would you do that for numbers, though? You could. I'll keep the bottom. But the option I really want to change is down here, where the sequence is, do I want to do it by the series or the category? The category is west, central, east. I want to do it by the series of data. So let me click that. And now it will appear in for each click is for each bar. So I can wait. Let me just show you here. Slideshow, current slide. Now as I click, and I can click the first two and talk about that really quick. I can talk about our third quarter. We fired the manager in the central district, so things are looking better in the central district. But then I want to talk about the fourth quarter. We really rocked the boat, and that's really led us to our new international domination in whatever we're doing. And then I can click and get that fourth. So again, the data is what I'm animating, not the structure. The graph did not fly onto the screen, just the data did. One last thing I want to talk about is motion. Let's say for our big change, we're no longer just a pharmaceutical company. We want to reveal now that we're also in hospitals and in healthcare, and that our overall, what we're looking at for folks is our overall wellness. So I have these shapes, and I want to reveal them with animation. But the thing is, all three shapes are buried right there. They're all stacked on top of each other. Let me show you something here, which is called the selection pane. Now, I have three shapes here. Here, I'll try to reveal them for you. So they're there. Let me undo that. Okay, they're all stacked up. If I go to the Home tab, there's a couple different ways to do this, but one is the Home tab, and there's the Arrange area. This is where you can bring things backwards and forwards. But at the bottom here is selection pane. It works pretty much like the animation pane. There's all my objects. In fact, you can name the objects. So if you want to make sure, you know, which one's the healthcare, which one's, you know, instead of box or rectangle, you can actually name them. And I can see each one. So here's the pharmaceuticals. It's made of two elements. It's made of a rectangle and a picture of a tree. And I can make those all disappear by clicking the little eyeball icon here to the right. So I'm going to click that. And now it's still there. I'm just not viewing it. I'm viewing the next down. Let me do the same thing. Healthcare. I can click that. And it all disappears, and now I'm looking at the wellness box. I can even just do one element. So let's say I want to make that rectangle around the heart disappear. I can do that also by doing those hide and show keys. Okay. So let's show all, and then let's animate this. So the pharmaceutical one, I want it to move. So I go to animations, and the animation I want to use is not entrance or emphasis. Down here at the bottom is motion paths, arcs, turns, loops, shapes. You can even customize it to whatever shape you want, ever movement. I'm just going to use a simple line, and the default is it moves down. And you see these dots. You see a green dot for the start and a red dot for the end. And then you can move those. I can move those anywhere I want to if I really wanted to. Move it all the way over here if I wanted to. But I'm just going to use a straight line. So I'm going to go up to Effect Options and choose, I want this one to slide to the left. No, I want that to slide to the right. So it gives me a little picture. And that's, and again, I could play with the timing if I wanted to, but that's fine. So now let me go over to pharmaceuticals, and I'll turn off pharmaceuticals. And now the healthcare, and I'll animate that. So let me get the animation paint up while I'm doing this. Okay. So I'm going to do healthcare, and I want that to move a line motion animation and not down, but effect options, and I want to move that one to the left. Okay. And then I'll bring back all my elements. So in the selection pane, show all. So again, I'm just seeing the pharmaceuticals, but you can see the lines that show the motion paths. So slideshow from current slide. So we're no longer just pharmaceuticals. We now are in hospitals around the world, and we're looking at people's wellness. So that's motion paths. There's a lot more about animation, but that's all the time we have for today. I have links to video training. I have links to all the help and how to articles of what I just showed you. I have also a lot more. We have pre-made, professionally made animated slides for both PowerPoint 2010 and 2013. Those are in the links at aka.ms/animation123. If you want to see how complex you can be with animation, there is a full movie that is made in PowerPoint. You'll be amazed. It's actually just animation in PowerPoint. I have a link to that and some stuff by Rick Altman. All that there. We'll have the video up for this webinar at aka.ms/animation123. Information about the Office webinar series in general, go to aka.ms/offweb. Next week, we'll be talking about tips for those big, long research papers or college papers. We'll be talking about that. But for today's Office webinar team, thank you for joining the Office 15-minute webinar.